right through the edge of the goal. Kreese now Getzlaf blocks a bit from Evander Kane. Half a minute to go in the period as Getzlaf chops it away from Kane, comes up with it, looks up and goes cross ice for Nate Thompson. Frolik just missed Kane at the blue line. Stoner with the prudent play just plays it out, and then Kane runs him. Vatanen comes over to answer for him, and Stoner just starts throwing. The initial penalty was coming up to Evander Kane here as he ran Clayton Stoner, but we'll see if there's any collateral damage from what took place afterwards.
Well, Stoner lands a couple of good ones. Kane, those gloves are pretty much glued on his hands. They're not coming off. So after he runs Clayton Stoner, he's not going to get involved in anything. Boy, that's a board face first into the glass for Stoner. That's why Vatanen comes over. It's why Stoner drops the gloves and just starts throwing them. Stoner's... they're sending to the locker room right now.
Well, there's only 10 and a half seconds left in the period here, so I think Evander...
Well, Washington really needs some offense now. They've had a dozen shots, some good chances. Here's Marcus Johansson with Kuznetsov and Williams. Justin Williams with a shot that was blocked by Dumoulin and sent to center. That's Marcus Johansson down on the ice. His stick went flying across the ice, and he needs some help.
Coming across, and... was it Chris Letang coming
in
there?
It is Letang.
And he caught him up. A little bit of a jump there by Letang as he got up. Let's see, does he leave his legs? At the end, he sure does. And this is a quiet, quiet arena here. Another opportunity. Is this just going to be two? They are huddling here to see if this should be a major or if this is just going to be a two-minute penalty.
Well, the debate is on.
Hamilton dumps it up into the corner. Frazier after it. Oh, he was popped and drops down. And he is ailing.
Oh, yes, he did.
That was Kadri.
Oh, yes, he did. The elbow was out. And you can see Kadri here saying, I don't really mean to do that. But he went flying right through in the collision and caught him right in the head. And
well,
he knocked him out.
And I don't think, look, I think he's just trying to squeeze through there. That wasn't intentional,
yep.
I don't think.
No.
And you can see Kadri apologizing.
Miller's pass. Kreider got a piece of it. Pavlik out to get it. The Bufflin. Hayes with a good play. Kreider turns. Stahl winds up. Save Pavlik. The rebound loose. And the Jets able to clear it out. Oh, Kevin Hayes. What a play he made.
Did Miller ever get cross-checked? It should have been a penalty on Bufflin. That was a vicious cross-check to Miller.
Violent, deliberate. Could have broken his neck. So... I don't know what's going to happen, but it was one of the most vicious cross checks I've seen this year.
Frank Corrado, but the Oilers maintain possession. Here comes Smith down low with Hemsky in the corner. A pass to the near side for Hall. Taylor Hall sidesteps hit. No, he didn't. Weiss got him with an elbow in the face and felled him quickly as the energy player for the Canucks gets the elbow up on the big star for Edmonton.
Horvat is the first one to take a penalty right here, a hooking penalty on Hall. And then this is a pretty obvious shot to the head from Weiss on Taylor Hall. That's the second time the Canucks have gone after Taylor Hall.
I wouldn't doubt it, Mark, if the league's going to look at that one.
That looks like a suspendable headshot there.
Miller steps up. Smith had it from behind. Florence Miller. He's going to go. Wow, Kevin Miller is not doing well right now. Dion Phaneuf came a substantial distance and smacked him right between the 8 and the 6.
But I'm hoping they at least follow up with a penalty on Dion Phaneuf on this hit right here. How is that not a penalty? This should be even strength.
He actually loads up.
But they want to call Seidenberg for a hit to the head earlier in the period.
Yeah, Phaneuf's gone.
Not before he tries to have a conversation with Chara.
Well,
Crawford steers it to the far side. The Blues have it. Now they'll try to set up again on their power play as Steen moves it along for Backes. Oh, Seabrook with a huge hit, and Backes is down, and he is not moving. And Steen comes right after Seabrook. Now Backes is getting up, and he's going to try to come right back at the player that hit him.
I don't think Backus realizes who hit him.
And I don't know that he is that right now. Yeah, he just fell down again. He tried to get up out of pure instinct, I think. He's leaning against the boards right away. He's having trouble staying on his feet.
And I think Ray Burley is just trying to calm him down right now.
Well, he's got him by the back of the jersey for more than just calming him down. Well, the officials are having a discussion about this hit, and how this is called and what it is called is going to be huge for this game and potentially the series.
No penalty called on the play. And Backus went down and was not moving at all.
Just as he turned.
Now the question is does Brent Seabrook leave his feet when he makes contact with the hit? It looks like the right skate is on the ice when he makes contact with David Backus. It looks like that right toe, Brian, is still on the ice.
That's true.
When you go and make those type of hits, you are inevitably going to leave your feet when you
get to Garrison. Behind the net, Smith's out of the goal. Oh, Edler hit it. And Edler's going to hear about it. Coyotes en masse, and here come the Canucks. A game that's had very little in the way of emotion just erupted as Alex Edler ran into the goaltender Smith, who'd already been injured in this period. And the Coyotes.
And here's Mike Smith now going after Alex Edler. And Corey Schneider is edging his way up. And you can see the Canuck bench waving at Corey to stay out of this. As the Canucks are on the power play, it's even manpower there. Alex Edler, is he going to get tossed out for that?
That's true.
But here, and Mike Smith stops it. Well, of course, you're right. That in contact with, although Alex was right there when the puck got there.
Well, it's a penalty for sure, but I'm just wondering if they threw him out of the game. Is that excessive?
Well, there's less than 2 minutes left here in the second period.
And if it's coincidental penalties, yes. Maybe. That's why. So we'll wait the official announcement as to what they've called.
Another look at it as the puck got there. Alex Edler takes out the goalie. And both referees had the arms up in the air.